Have you pushed that private parking ticket to the back of the drawer of doom, hoping that it'll just go away itself? It isn't wise to just ignore your parking ticket, and I'll get on to how much motorists ended up shelling out in court soon. Let me explain a little bit about your parking ticket first. The moment you pull up on a private land car park, you're entering into a contract and you're agreeing with the T&Cs that should be clearly described on a sign. Most supermarkets and health sectors employ car park operators to oversee that the rules aren't broken. If you don't park within a bay properly, park in a disabled spot without displaying a badge, ignore the paying display, or stay longer than you're allowed, that's when you're likely to be issued with a parking ticket. You've got 28 days to appeal a parking ticket. If it gets rejected, you can escalate it to the Independent Appeal Service. I'll put a link to that in the description. A parking ticket on private land could cost you up to £100, and next year this could be capped by the government. In a second, I'll give you some examples of a couple of big cases that went to court, but first, I want to let you know what happens if you ignore the parking ticket. Letters come through your door, the car park operator sends through payment reminders which get more and more threatening, they employ a debt collection agency. They turn up at your door chasing you for payment. You get called to the small claims court. You have to appear in court, and if you lose, you'll have to potentially pay a lot of money and get issued with a CCJ, which affects your credit score. The parking ticket is now seen as a debt, which is why it affects your credit history. It's always a bit of a gamble when you appeal against private parking tickets. Even when the evidence shows the parking charge is wrong, a court could still rule against you. Here are a couple of examples of how it goes wrong. A 28-year-old woman had to pay out a massive amount of cash because she repeatedly ignored parking tickets. She kept on parking outside her dad's house without a permit, and that mistake cost her over 20 grand. Parking Eye versus Barry Beavis is another very famous court case that escalated to Supreme Court. Barry had gone over his parking limit in a private land car park by nearly an hour, and there were about 20 signs in the car park that were large, prominent, and legible. Unfortunately for him, he lost the fight, and it was ruled in Parking Eye's favour, and the law has been clarified by this case. The best thing to do when you receive a parking ticket on private land is either gather loads of information to support your appeal and try your luck, or pay the ticket early while you get the discounted rate. Don't just ignore it in the hope it might go away. One way to get a quick answer to see whether you might have any joy appealing is by speaking to a solicitor. There may be someone you know locally, or you could get a really quick response online with Just Answer solicitors. For the sake of a fiver, you could save yourself a load of money. There's a link in the description if you want to check it out and support my channel.